Hello everyone, thank you for joining us for the first live webinar by Erlang Solutions in 2020. I'm really excited about this one, building Tetris in Elixir. We first found Sandesh's blog and version of it last year and got in touch with him, and we thought it was such a great example of live view and what you can do with it, and such a fun activity to help learn Elixir and some of the things that it can do. And since then, we've been very proud to sponsor Bruce Tate's video series of the same sort of concept, learning to build Tetris in Elixir. It's such a great idea. This webinar in particular is done in conjunction with ElixirConf EU, who will be at a later date hosting a version of the code you're seeing today on their website. All of the details of that will be in the email that we send out next week following up this. That will also have your recording of this webinar, so keep a lookout for your in your inbox for that. I think without any further ado, I think it's time to introduce Sandesh and have a look at the webinar you've signed up for. Have fun, and over to you, Sandesh.
Greetings everyone, I'm pretty excited for the webinar. Thanks Erlang Solutions for hosting and attendees for joining. Okay, I organize Elixir Pune and Elixir Bangalore meetups. We also have Elixir community in Delhi and Hyderabad. We have built a good audience in India. Hopefully we will organize Elixir Conf this year or the next. Okay, let's start. Okay. So, what will be built today? So, like all the components, like shape, rules, manip, logic, tiles. So, this is what we expect. These tiles, add tiles to board. Now, shape should rotate, shape should move, place on the other shape. Now, when other shape is placed, the lane is matured, move that lane and pull the tiles. Now our flow today, we expect the webinar to run for around 100 minutes. So in simple words, we are just building the app and few of the things, and then general server and live app. So we have to run as fast as possible. If you have any doubts and queries, you can surely tweet me or email me, and I will try to blog a detailed explanation of all your questions, answering every question of why this approach, why that approach. We can have a discussion. You will be able to find a blog with a title around like the status Kachuri facts. Okay, so let's start. So to start with coordinate system. Today we will be like some quick theory, some animation, then code, then again slides, again some explanation with animation, then code snippets. We'll cheat a little bit and again code, and this will keep flowing. Okay, so to start with coordinate system, this is a tile, this is a shape. Now shape inside board, now board with coordinates. If you can see that on the top we have x-axis, on the left we have y-axis. X-axis grows from left to right and y-axis grows from top to bottom. Now the coordinates of the shape, like 4, 5, this one, if you can see this 4, 5. Now board will have offset x and offset y. Okay, what is offset and why? So okay, look at the pin. So this is a pin. Now the coordinates of shape are there, 4, 5. Now we can also say that it is 3 + 1, 5 + 0. This one, 3 + 0, 3 + 1, this way. And similarly, the other shapes will be like, we start with 0, on the left it's plus x, when you go down y-axis similarly. So this shape also, so we have this shapes of T shape, L shape, box shape, S shape. Coming back to previous shape, So here we had, it was pin and the shape, 10100101. Okay, the next concept, the lanes and the index are in board. So we have this board with all these shapes, and we know that this lanes should move and the others should come down. So for that reason, we are conceptualizing this way. So every Y is a lane. So like even if it's this way, lane are shaking, and every lane has tiles. If you see lane and tiles were moving this way. Okay, now let me quickly explain the game model. Okay, first we have board, this board, active shape, the next shape, score component, so offset x. So like where this place shape should be, that will be decided by offset x and offset y. Okay, and game state, which is game state says, is it active, is the game over or is it running? Speed is optional, we are not covering it. To quickly recap, we saw we have coordinates, shape, offset, board has width, height, lanes, and game has game state, score. So let's start with the code. Okay, so I have already created a project, and the project has this it is umbrella project. So we will create new in this umbrella, we'll create a new project. So it's created. Sorry. In the apps, we need to create a okay. So we are here. Now we start writing the code. So for, we will create the core models. We'll start with shape. So we saw shape has coordinates, color. It will also have a length. Why we need length? This is for the rotation. We can safely ignore it for now. Length. Now we have T shape, box shape, S shape, line shape. We can have even more. For now, I'm just taking these ones. So the code of T shape will look like this one. Remember the in the slides I showed you. The coordinates, so T shape, box shape, S shape, line shape. Now we'll need a function for def new random. For that we'll say T shape, box shape, line shape, shape, num dot random new. So this way a new one is given. Now let's code the board. So board is made up of the attributes are width, height, lanes, indexer. So what is indexer? For now, let's ignore it. And it is just to every lane has an index key. For now, that's what we can say. So to create a new pod, we need to have lanes. Lanes is empty index, and indexer is also empty. For the width and height, okay, we will get them. Also, we shall just specify 20. And key. So game is made up of four active shape, next shape, offset x, offset y, score, current state to say if the state is a game over or not. If we will miss any, we are good for now. To start with new, we say offset x. Okay, offset x, ideally it should be width by 2. For now I'm just making it 5, and offset will always be 1. Score should be 0. Current state okay. Okay, we have written the core game core models. So let's see the next slides. What we need. Okay, next we will need rules, a boundary mentioning the rules. The rules we need are so this is our board. Now these are the possible shapes, possible locations. Now this one is it the rule is the shape inside board x-axis. So this one is yes it is, this one it is not, this one is also out of the board, this one yes it is inside, this one is no, it is not. Okay, now next rule we need is the shape inside board y-axis. So this one is yes, it is in. This one, yes, it is in. This one, no, it goes out of the board. Now next next rule we need, does the shape collide with any board tiles? So this one, yes, it collides. This one, yes, it collides. This one, does not collide. Now the gravity rule, this one is a little difficult. Okay, is it free flow? Is there a tile below? Yes, there is a tile below. Here is also a tile below. There is no tile below. Okay, so let's quickly recap. we need rules to check shape. Is the shape inside the board? Yes. The shape does not, both x-axis and y-axis, shape does not collide with bow ties, and shape does not touch ground, that is gravity. So let's code the rules we need. Okay, and this one, I made a line. Okay, let's start writing the boundary. So the input are board, shape, and the coordinates, offsets. So I'm matching here itself the offsets. Now we say shape dot coordinates. We check tile one by one. If any one tile does not satisfy, then it is a false. So we need x comma y. This one is for the x shape inside board for the x, so we can safely ignore y. Now let me say ux, because I need a calculation of x plus offset x. So if ux is less than both dot width and ux greater than 0, say continue. True. Else, if any condition fails, then it's halt, comma, false. Similarly, okay, this one was for x. Similarly, we have need one diff. Same again, shape dot coordinates. Num dot radius while. So here we will not need a x1, we will just need a y. And we say, well, we just need y plus offset y. If this is great, more than board dot height, then this is our outside. Okay. And so if this is less than board dot height, then it is let's say continue and true. Else hold and say it is false. Now third rule, does the shape collide with tile? Or just say so again, shape board shape Now, in this case, we need put x comma y, and we say if tile present at, so if the board contains this tile at the position of x plus offset x, so if a tile is present, say else continue, so we have this three rules. Now let's see the next thing what we need. We have the this for no, we are not complete yet. Inside the board and no collision. Okay, now we have this the rules. Now we need something, let's say I will call them APIs. Now this is some extra work, but I like this. I prefer this. It helps the code understandable. So the API is validated. X again. Board shape offsets do. So we say if shape inside board X same board shape offsets, this should say okay and code, and if there is an false, say error and say outside X. Similarly validated by so if you can just say outside or outside y, not big, it was almost same. Now again for diff validated collision, you can say it, no collision, collision, it's up to you to decide what is more readable to you, and then accordingly. So in this case, if there is a collision, here we say error, collision, else, okay, four. Okay, we have seen the rules. Now let's come to the next concept we need, how we'll see the rules. Okay, now the board manager will just do the thing of adding a shape to board. This one is added to board. Now again, this one is added to board, and it also has a task to remove the matured lanes from the board and pull down the lanes. Okay, so okay. You can call it pod manager or any other name, what sounds good to you. For now, I'm just writing the function name and keeping it as it is. We'll come back to this later if time permits. I think the function name and the params are self-discretionary. Okay, for the shape rotation, if you see this one, this is a shape, but actually these are the four tiles. So when we rotate, this change this way and then this way. So what happens in this is we have the length. Every time we'll subtract the length from every coordinates, and that's how we do the rotation. We might not cover this today, but in the code which will be available, everything is there. Now let's come to the game logic. Now we need function that will say, that will allow us to move left, move right, move down. Now in case of this, there is a tile below the gravity thing, gravity functions, and if there was a tile below, place the shape there. Place the shape there, and the next shape became the active shape, and the next shape is again a new shape. This way, this is placed. Now next shape change, and I also changed. Okay, so for the next shape we need left, right, down, and rotate, and the gravity ring. So let's code that part. I'm calling it game logic. You can call it game manager or anything, and that's fine. Okay, to move a game to the left, when a left key is pressed. Now there, this is an interesting part. Let me expand a game here. So this is a game. Now I need a width, and I will say u offset x. No, we'll say u coordinates. So in this complete webinar, wherever I'm updating something and which we need, so I will start with a u underscore. Okay, then the big and important thing here, when we say left, it should here, when I say left, it should decrement by one. When I say right, x should increment by one. When I say down, the y should increment by one. So here I am saying minus one. Now I will pass all those valid. Now I will need those validations here, which we added in the rules. So we don't need a pod. I'm adding underscore pod rules dot. Tetris boundary. So rules.validate x, and we said we need board, so it's board here, shape is here, and we'll need the coordinates, that is u coordinates. Board shape is actually the active shape, which in the context, and u coordinates, updated coordinates. Now when this is valid on x, again we need to make sure valid y. And then we need to say okay comma for the test for the collision. I might have used some similar name, I'm just writing there. We will fix it at the end and map and fix properly. So if all these three are true, we should move it, move the offset to the left. So we'll just say game, and offset x is ux comma uy. So it's actually offset actually, but okay, let me correct them. We'll fix that later. Sorry for taking time. Okay, this one, now when there is an error, we say if the error is outside x, we just say we just return the game. Similarly, when it's outside y, or if there is a collision, we just say return game as it is. Now similarly we need move right, move down. So for the sake of time, I'm just copy paste, that is expander snippets. So this way I moved right. So move down. Now for the rotation, we'll skip the rotation for today. We'll have and the gravity. Okay, so what does the gravity do? Gravity do does the job of moving the active shape down every 1 second or 500 milliseconds, whatever is set by the game, and it will check if there is a tile. It will apply the logic of if there is a tile below, then place the shape there, and if it is the last, if it is a if it is a like last one, if it is this last lane, then insert the shape there. So that is the thing of gravity. Rotation, we are done. Okay, I think we'll come back to this gravity one again, and let's start with the game session gen server. Okay, we had missed a board manager part of adding the shape and removing the lens. Let's continue this one and then move to the next one. So when we add a shape, first we need to collect all the tiles. Now we are adding tile one by one. So we hold. X comma Y of the tile. And the color of the tile. And we will need, as we are placing a key, so we will need this one, we need random unique. Now we have boards board.indexer and board.lines. So in the indexer, first we need to add the Y. We need to find the white tile, that is lane. If it is not there, then we will place. We are searching in the board indexer for the Y, that is lane. If it is not present, generate a lane and add that to the indexer. Now that now the lane key for this added will be indexer of Y, that is see, Y is the line number. We search for line number. If it is found, then we get. If it is not found, then we add. And then finally we want the key in which the lane is present. Now the lane if the lane was present, we get that. If it is not present, we just create an empty map. Now in this so we have this lane. Now we need to add this x with the color. So in the lane we are adding x, that is if it is 3, 4 we are adding that, and the color. So the lanes we need will be now we also need to return this, so I'm saying u underscore lanes, and then I add it to the board. This one can be confusing, but it helps to reduce the computing whenever there is a, okay, to quickly imagine, when a lane is matured, we move that lane and we remove that lane, and the lanes which were above the lanes, like if these two lanes are removed, the lanes which were above, we just move them down. If we move each and every tile, that will be difficult, so we are just moving the lane down. Okay, now removing the lanes from the board. We can say lane numbers or lane indexes, like in this one, if these two lanes are to be removed, we will get lane number 5 and lane number 6 a list of 5, 6 here. So we say first we find the keys. So this way, I from the indexer, we took the keys of the links which are to be removed. Now we will just remove the links. Now this way we have removed. We have just removed the lanes and indexes, but this is actually this is one is not sufficient. The rest of the lanes should be moved down. So for that, we have boot out indexer. Remove those. Remove the lane numbers we have from the input. Okay, I will just skip this one for now. This is a long one. So here we will just check on the lane number and the lanes which we remove, we'll check how many were the less than the above lane, and that way we increment the index. In the code that will be explanatory. Now let's jump to the game session, and later we will see if the time permits we'll do the gravity part. The game session, we have this chain server is running, and we will have different state listeners for every client. So let's start coding for it. the game logic we described from there, we'll just say, we can just say rotate. Now we have come to the game session part. So we'll need one new thing. Now we will need a state change listener. Now this is possible here. Different clients will have different state change. So we need a state change listener. So now in the Tetris we have here, this is start game, start new game, start game session. So I can hear what you say. Game logic dot So the rotate and move are the easy one. Now the important one we need is a state change listener. So first we'll write a helper private function for that. Okay, this is a bit confusing. So let's write the live view code, and then we'll come back again to the state change listener, notify game change, and from here we will say notify game change, and we will also have one more tick function, a function with a name tick, so that will start adding the gravity and move the tiles, move the active shape down by incrementing offset y of one by every 500 milliseconds. So let's start with the front end. So one of the rules we skipped is how to check if a lane is matured. We just simply take a lane and take a count of the tiles inside it. If the count of that lane, tiles of lane is equal to board.width, we decide this lane is mature and this has to be removed. So this code will come under the rules, or it can come under board manager, it's up to you. Okay, so let's start writing the live view code. We need the core models here again. So next, mount session socket. Now, okay, and game session ID, and game session ID is we had written this Tetris dot start. Here, start game session. This one will actually do the thing of calling the chain server. This will ask the chain server to start link. Along with the PIDs, we are also sending a width and default width and default height, which we expect. I have set it to 20 and height is I specified 15. We can change it anyhow. Now again, the move will all make a call to gen server. For again, rotate will say gen server call. So this start link start game session returns us game session ID, which is what we need. And we also passed an argument of state change listener. So the state change listener, we passed argument of this listener PID, and we are setting it as state change listener. Like remember the, if you remember the game core model, there we specified state change listener, and the value is we are passing as listener PID, and which will pass from here. And the listener PID will be self. Now next thing, new socket. We need to create this socket, and for that we will need a function, something that will take the arguments and set them. For now, I'll just generate socket from state. So I have passed him, just used a snippet. So this way, from the state, it takes all the board active shape. And it is assigned to the socket. And this one is PID, game session PID. Now we need the state in there, so we take this way. Now in this newly created socket, we have to assign the server ID. Going back to this slide, this way, the gen server of game session. So I will say this way, this one was correct and is added here. Now the live view will, should we expect the live view? First one is render function to render the assigns. We have to write the code for HTML, so we'll write that soon, and we need this one. We need to handle events that will be move. So now we will first write the HTML part that for the live view, then we'll come here and we'll see how the values are passed for the live view, then from live view, how it will code, it will be sent to OTP, and then we'll come to the state change listener. I have all loaded all the CSS necessary CSS. So now we have I have container inside the Tetris container. Inside it, I have a board container. Inside the board container, I will have a grid, Tetris grid. Now in the Tetris grid, this is a grid and every tile, this is a grid and every tile is one grid. So how big is the grid, and that will be a board temp, board width and board height. So temp grid template columns. And the rows, so rows are board.height. Now inside this grid, we need to place the active shape and the board tiles. So I have from the active shape, I'm taking the coordinates as of x and y. I'm placing each tile as a in the grid. So for that, Now the color is background color. Hopefully the align is correct, and after the shape we place the we are placing the lanes and then tiles which are in the pool. We have all this indexer. Indexer is here. We took this indexer from board, lanes also from the board. Now from this we got the lane. Now we need more. We need to get the tiles. So for now again the same style. There is a change will be here. Grid row is the lane, that is why. And grid column is the X. And instead of active color, we have this one color, line number 24. Now the next thing we have is in the outside we show the next shape and the score which I will skip. Now, just to give better context, We have seen the active shape is here, and every time the offset x and offset y is incremented. So for that, and the move, to add the live view, we have to add here. So whenever the arrow key is placed, pressed, so this Phoenix key up. This event will be called with a move. So here we get move, and the move, and the second one, the second argument will be the code, and it will say which key is pressed. So we have pattern matching and getting the key here, and from the socket. Now again we will see. Case key, what key is it? So if it's arrow, right, we want it to move. Tetris dot move to right. So if the key is left, move to the left. The key is down, move accelerate the down, and if the key is up, that is rotate. And if it's some other key, just skip this. Now to take to make this working, we need game session ID. Which we will collect from the socket. Now we'll have to sign this in the Tetris. So here we present it and the appropriate command for. Here it is just one parameter, so just interrogate it. And we'll say no reply. Next, the next important thing we need is state change listener. So every time there is a, whenever we say move or rotate, we just send there, but we don't collect anything. And now we will have to collect. We collect with the handle info, because the process is going to send. Send it to this process ID. So handle info, and the message will a pattern match with this message, state change, the new state, okay. Now we have the new state, updated state, which the gen server has sent. Now so we will take this socket and state and make the new assigns. So I know this must be a bit confusing, but as you code, this will be more clear. Now, so to show from this Phoenix key up, this will trigger the events for the live view to move left or right or down or rotate. Now this then this will be from here we catch them and we send them to game session, which is we send them to Tetris from move here. From here we say this moves makes appropriate calls to game session and says which direction or rotate. And then whenever there is a new updated state, we just took the new state. Now we need to send a new state with like this way, notify game change listener. So from there, when a message is sent, the message is sent, state change this message. So when this message is sent, state change to state change listener. The state change listener will be reflected here in the live view. Here, when it receives a message of state change and a new state, line number 26, state change and a new state, state change and a new state. So this must make a call, send message, and then this will reflect to the front. Now, we need to complete this one so that the new states are sent. So we'll just say notify game changed. Game state is the old state, and we send next state. Similarly here, notify game change, game state to the new state. Now this one is to just show the left, right, down. Now we need a mechanism that every 1 second the timer should increase and the clock is increasing, so the y with gravity one should be called, so the active shape moves down by one, so offset y is increased by one. So for that we say tick, the next state will always be game logic dot move and pass this game state, and the move is gravity, so that the gravity related things are carried out. Now it should be repeated. So send again the tick, and I have specified 500 milliseconds. You can specify 300 or 1000 as per how much you want. Again, this is no reply. Now this will not start automatically, so we need to do here. In the init, we need to send it once. Send a message to self, save tick. Now this much is not sufficient. It should not continuously do this. At some time, there must be game over. So how will we know if there is a game over? So when we come back to the rules, we have a rule for in the move for the gravity, one of the error messages will detect if the game is over or it is not. So for that, there will be a rule which will say, which will detect and appropriate stage, it will return an error message that error, game over. That time it will go to the error of move gravity, and that way there will be a step for game over. And like the input, the current state will change to game over. And so this has to be checked this will be checked in the game session. Here the condition will be applied if after the next state dot equal to game over, say so if the state is game over, we stop here and say game over, else we again send back the tick which will keep continuing. Now I see we are 11:15. Hi Anthony, can we continue for 5 more minutes? Okay, let's continue. So this is what I can do. This way we have reached a game over, and I'll quickly finish the slides and show you a working demo which I have. So the code of the code of working version is on this repo right now. This is private. I will make it available after this, make it public after this webinar. You can changes are pull requests are open if you have, if you think, if you believe you have a better version, feel free to add your PRs. The next big things I'm planning, property based videos, like complete 2-hour or 3-hour videos for property based testing, surface component library. Maybe I will try to use the surface library components for this Tetris. Now solving advent of course advent of code exercises will take the 2019 exercise. It will, this will be the for the beginner audience, so that all the concepts are taken. Now for the spawn fest, last year I also participated in spawn fest. I will participate this year again, and I hope I will beat President Mario for the spawn fest. It should be in second half of the year. So if you have any questions, you can mail me, and yes, you can Google for the Tetris Kachori facts, facts, and if they are, if you do not find answer there, you are free to mail me and I will try to answer them. Anthony, are you here?
Yeah.
Let me quickly show you a working demo of the product, which I have locally, and cool. Then I will pass the screen to you.
Cool. Just while Sandesh is getting the working version of the game going, if you do have any questions straight after that demonstration, we'll be able to ask Sandesh them. So please do send your questions through on the GoTo app.
Okay, this is the working, this is the working code. Okay, I will pass. I have shown the working demo. The code is on GitHub. After I'll probably make it public tomorrow.
Cool.